Why does everyone want to be my sugar daddy? Am I the only one that if some random guy just says,
"Hello, dear,"
you're like,
or is it just me? Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, which is going to be another new makeup releases because it's Saturday. I have quite a few things to chat about, but I have a lot of sneak peeks. And if you're new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup commentary, if you love everything makeup, if you love to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, and if you want to be entertained, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. We are still in a band as well, which is now post-Halloween, but nightmare before Christmas. Yes. My eye look is pretty dramatic. I didn't film it. I just went playing. I used the Oud palette from Odin's Eye. I also used some new falsies that came in, which are half lashes from Vive Cosmetics. And honestly, they are about the width of my usual lashes, because my eyes aren't that big. So for me, they are more along the lines of normal lashes that I don't have to cut. So yeah. There's that. But those I'm wearing, my eyes also very, very teary. So let's hope that everything stays on today. And on my lips is a combination between the shade Arrival in a lipstick and a gloss in the shade Paradox. Both are from Lethal. Yes, I'm still also very much loving the Lisa Eldridge foundation, which I have on my face today as well. I did powder it. And it's looking very, very nice. Just saying. I did a first impression with the Lisa Eldridge foundation. That is online on my channel. If I don't forget, I will link it for you guys. Yeah, let me go to the side. So I can put pictures up there.
Why does everyone want to be my sugar daddy?
Never mind. Never mind that at all. Am I the only one that if some random guy just says, "Hello, dear," you're like, or is it just me? Never mind. Never mind. Yes, let's start with something that's not makeup related. Because, oh yes, and if you are new, I also love to incorporate other stuff than just makeup, just to keep it a little bit interesting and to do my own thing that no one else is doing. Yes, let's start with this, which is Gift by Gaia UK. And yeah, it's in the UK. What are they? They are crystals with mushrooms attached. They're just so cool. I love mushrooms. I love this type of whimsical stuff, and I love crystals, so what's not to love? I think this is very, very pretty, very cool, very artistic, stunning. But I also have another picture, and that is from the upcoming new collection, which is dedicated to the moon. And you see here three, I think, pendants. These are stunning. They are so, so pretty. What is it? Labradorite and rainbow moonstone. Yeah, very, very pretty. I will link the site down below. Go check them out. Yes, again, stunning, stunning, stunning. I love this. With a passion. Let's go next to... Yeah. Let's go to something that I am... It could very well be that I have bought, because I am filming this on Thursday. It launches today. You are seeing this on Saturday. I think I bought this. And let's just say if I miss out on the initial launch, I will buy it when it restocks. And that's from ColourPop. And that is the Mandalorian collection. I already have the child palette, the Baby Yoda. And I know it's not Baby Yoda, but I'm just going to call it Baby Yoda because everyone does. But I have the child palette here. And the Mandalorian, I actually really, really, really like this color story. I also love the mirror. I love a lot of things from this collection. Honestly. So, but I at least want to pick up the palette. And maybe even the gloss sets. And for the rest, I actually don't know. I really like this color story a lot. I also have swatches. The swatches are from Amanda from Makeup Just For Fun. You know what's getting me, right? That freakishly mustard yellow. I'm very much into the neutral shades right now. And this, I don't know, this just looks so stunning. I won't get it on launch. I won't get it very, very quickly. But I still really want this. So, I have either bought it or I am planning on buying it. just so you know. Let me know down below if you have gotten anything from the collection, because it has already dropped and I will link it down below. Let me know. Then the next thing that I have is also from Colourpop that will launch, I think, Friday, which is their upcoming holiday collection. Honestly, I like the Mandalorian palette more. I think that the layout is pretty. I like the way that it is looking, but it's, at least from the picture that I have here, just a basic neutral palette, which I'm not really hating. But yeah. Oh, it's a little bit more yellowy toned. Roaring Hearts, that's what it's called. Yeah, it's basically a neutral palette. And while I like the color story, now that I see different pictures, I do kind of like the color story. I also kind of have it. And honestly, I have last year's holiday release, which is the Boudoir. No, I don't know, the one with the yellowy and the greeny. I did not really like that quality that much. The palette is very heavy duty, but I don't know, I felt like Colourpop has better quality than that one. Let me know if you are excited about this. If I were to have it, I would create stunning looks with it, honestly, because I think that neutrals look gorgeous on, well, almost everyone. But yeah, it's not something that I was planning on picking up. Yeah, as I said, the Mandalorian, yeah, for the rest, it looks to be a little bit 20s inspired, actually, the collection, which I do like, but it's not really something that I'm, it's a dime a dozen, honestly. I think that the Mandalorian is more interesting. Let me know your thoughts, though. Let's go next to Lethal Cosmetics, because they are showing us a multi-chrome, I think. And it looks stunning. It says here, something new is coming on November 26th, along with their biggest Black Friday sale yet. And I also have some information on their Black Friday sale. It's save the date, hashtag Black Friday 2021, sale up to 45% off. It says Friday, November 26th at midnight CET, which is Central European time. So maybe you want to mark your calendar. I don't know. For the rest, I did not have any newness from Lethal except those two things. Another sneak peek that I have is from Alien Cosmetics. Yeah, you see a box. It's not Mean Girls inspired, because that was asked and it wasn't. I don't really know what it is. I think it's her holiday collection. And I think it will include a palette and three either lippies or liquid eyeshadows, maybe. Looking at what you can put in the box. And then the next one that I have is what I think is going to go in that box, which is three. Yeah, it could be liquid eyeshadows. It could be lippies. That is it. So I don't know exactly what she's going to do, but I am very excited about it. And if I have more information, I will let you know. But so far, yeah, I think it's basically a holiday collection, a palette and three, I'm almost guessing lippies. Let me know your guesses down below. Let's go next to Saints, Angels, Sinners. Yeah, so last week I mentioned the Happy New Year palette, and this is the A Grateful Heart palette. Both are live right now, and I will leave the site down below. And yeah, I think that this is coming my way as well. Now, this also looks stunning. So yeah, thank you so much. And I cannot wait to schmied it on the face. Honestly, I cannot wait. Then I also have two other things, because she's also going to release two 6-pan eyeshadow palettes. One is called Over the Moon and the other one Guardian Movement, if I'm not mistaken. These, oh yeah, the Over the Moon with the purple and the greeny. Yeah, stunning. And basically what you have is a shimmer and then a corresponding matte. And I really, really like that. Both color stories look gorgeous, and I think that they are dropping somewhere in December. If I know when, I will let you know, but I will leave the site down below. Yeah, as of yet, I haven't tried her brand yet. And as I mentioned last week, stuff is coming my way in PR. I'm very, very interested. Let me know your thoughts. And I heard from a few of you who have tried the brand that the quality is very, very nice. I cannot wait to try it. So Yeah, thank you, Saints, Angels, Sinners, for sending stuff my way. It's always exciting, always. Yeah, I cannot wait to see it in person and to try it. And let me know your thoughts down below. Let's go next to Catrice and Essence. Catrice and Essence are sister brands. In case you don't know, they also have another sister brand, which is LOV, which you usually don't hear a lot about because it's more sold in Germany. I can get it here as well. It's a little bit of the higher end sister. It's the more expensive sister, basically like me. Yes, but anyway, Essence and Catrice are going to collab. They do that every so often, and they are going to do the Princess Sister Love Limited Edition. So I am kind of seeing Ariel. I am seeing Belle. I don't really know. I think it's skincare, face palette, eyeshadows and such. I'm interested to see what they are doing. It's not always the most exciting color stores that they come up with, but I do love both brands and I'm always interested to see what they are doing. So yeah, usually for Europe, I link Cosmetic for Less. Now, if I am not mistaken, Cosmetic for Less is also shipping to the USA right now, but I could be mistaken. So yeah, Essence and Catrice, I usually link Cosmetic for Less because it serves a wide variety of people. Otherwise, just check where your Essence and Catrice is sold, which is basically on their own sites right now, I think at least. So yeah, let me know if you are excited. I'm interested to see what they are doing. And if I have more information, I will let you know. Oh Lord, more sneak peeks. The next sneak peek is on its way. And I hope that by the time you are seeing this, I have it in-house because I know it's coming. And that is from Nomad Cosmetics. It is their holiday palette. It says here, holiday lights and festive nights inspired by sparkling holiday lights in winter's dark nights. Close your eyes, you can picture them right. Love seeing the shades of this new limited edition palette all together before we assemble them. The launch date is Tuesday the 16th, 11 a.m. EST, 8 a.m. PST or 4 p.m. GMT. And this looks like a fun, colorful palette. And I cannot wait. I also have kind of a picture of the outside. They have done something like this before with their Studio 54 collection. They also did kind of a cutout thing with sparkly bits behind it. And I cannot wait to see the final palette. As I said, I know it's coming my way. When it's here, I'm going to start filming with it immediately, and I hope to have the video up as soon as possible. Let me know if you are excited. If you want to order this, I do have an affiliate code which will be listed down in the description box. Next, I am going to go to Rebel Rouge Labs for the Can I Exist palette. And let's see, what is the information that I have? It's a moody winter palette inspired by John Carpenter's The Thing. It will, let's see, November the 5th to November the 21st, so that's now. It's the pre-order window and the orders will ship to you early to mid-December. There will also be an estimated 15 to 20 business days production and processing window after pre-order closes on the 22nd. If you order any ready-to-ship items with the pre-order, everything will basically hold and everything will ship at the same time. That's what they are saying. So let me go to the color story. I don't have the palette, but I do have arm swatches here. It's an interesting color story. But I think that they are doing very, very interesting things. It's a brand that I definitely have my eye on. Now, I'm not particularly looking to add new brands to my collection right now because I'm having a hard time reviewing everything for you guys. So this brand is still on my radar and it is still on my wish list, and maybe I will try them. I'm falling off the screen next year, but right now I think I'm kind of all set with everything that I want to try, everything that's coming in. But yeah, let me know your thoughts. Have you pre-ordered it, or are you going to pre-order? Let me know down below. The next thing, again, it's the episode of sneak peeks, honestly. This is from Dandelions Co. And these are some shades from their winter palette. And what I see here, I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shades, which are gray and then bluer gray, I cannot wait to see the final color story. Again, it's a brand. Yes, they are doing singles. And if you know me a little better, you know that I'm more of a palette person. But they, when they release a singles bundle, and you can still get it as a bundle, I can almost see it as a palette. Because that's then how I would use it, you know? This color story is stunning, though. This is a color story that I really, really love. Now, if I know the final color story, I will let you know what it looks like. Usually, you can buy it basically in a palette. Or you can buy them as singles. Have you tried Dandelions Co? Again, this is another brand that is on my list of brands that I still want to try. And I'm very interested to see the final palette. Let's see. Oh yeah, the shades will be available as singles for $4.50. The palette pricing will be the same as the past two palettes, which is $40 for just a bundle of eyeshadows and $50 if you want to include the palette that you can put them in as well. So yeah. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know. What else do I have? Rising Phoenix makeup. And I am missing, as I'm filming this, three shades of their new palette, but maybe by the time I'm done editing, or before I'm done editing, I have the final color story. This is the Resist, Desist, and Vanquish palette. It says here, in the collection, the Story Weaver, which is Vedelam, and the Warrior Monk refers to the duo King Vikra Madithan, I believe, and the Spectre Vedelam, teaser trailer too. I think it's movie inspired this time, but I have no idea though. I'm reading off the post. Their adventures together were scribed on palm leaves in the 6th century, and later poetry was written. Oh, it's a saga. Was written about them in the 11th century. Some say this is fiction. Well, some say that these were based on true events, as the places mentioned in the tales exist even today. Both of them are not Singapore-based, but they are well-known by Indians in Singapore. And the brand is based in Singapore. Same for the Chinese warrior monk, Taoist master priest Cao from Mr. Vampire movie series. He defeats Zhang Xi. Featured as Living Dead in our Dissident and Defiance palette, well known by the Chinese in Singapore. While Medicine Man is commonly found in Malaysia, he is well known by the Malays here. Hence, we have these three characters from other countries to represent their three communities in the aspect. And then there's a whole story behind the palette. I will link the Instagram post where I'm reading this from down below, so you can read the story. If I'm not mistaken, this is an all shimmer palette, but it's a very nice grungy color story. Have you ever tried Rising Phoenix makeups? I haven't as of yet, but again, this is also a brand that I have my eye on. I am not really into all shimmer palettes though. Well, not really. I am not into all shimmer palettes because I just prefer to have a combination of mattes and shimmers. Yes, I know I can pull in mattes, but the way that I did my shadow today, basically pulling a few different bits here and there, I love to do it, but it's not something that I have, that I'm doing often, because I just don't have the time for it usually. So that is why I usually don't go for all shimmer palettes, because they kind of get lost a little bit in my collection, if that makes any sense. But it does look very, very pretty. Let me know your thoughts down below. Yes, let's next go to Give Me Glow, because this is the palette called Bad Witch Club. Was it already live? Let me see. I thought I knew. The 26th of November it is going live. It says here, Halloween may be over, but witches are always in season. Yes, I agree. I have my, can you see my nails? Spidery, webby thingies. I did it myself. The video is online on my nail channel. If I don't forget, I will link it. Otherwise, my nail channel is always linked down in the description box. But yeah, I agree. It's always Halloween season. What can I say? So yeah, I really like this theme. I like the fact that there are brands that are still just going with it. I like the artwork. I like the color story as well. It's not specifically for me, right now at least. But I really do like the way that this is looking. So let me know your thoughts down below. Are you excited? Are you picking it up? let me know. I will leave the site down below for you to check out. Okay, what else do I have? What was this again? Lunatic Labs, I believe. Yes, Lunatic Cosmetics Labs. This is the Mortician's show. And I know that one of you, or at least one of you, is the... Was it the daughter or the granddaughter of a mortician? You said so. But I don't remember if it was your granddad or your dad that was a mortician, which I find extremely fascinating, by the way. So... When I saw this, I immediately thought of you. I just, yeah, what can I say? This is the Mortician's Show. It's a face palette of 6 unique creamy matte shades that you could also use on your eyes. It's available now for $44.54. Is it maybe from pounds to dollars? Because is Lunatic Cosmetics UK based? I actually don't remember. But this looks, it looks stunning. The palette looks stunning. It's not a face palette that I would use as a face palette. A yellow blush, I tried it, but because I am a warmer olive, a yellow blush can look like I have been punched in the face. And it's just not pretty. If you are warm though, but also if you are cool toned, I think a yellow blush then kind of shifts a little bit, especially if you're cool toned, it goes a little bit with... The pink of your own face is kind of coming through then. So that's very pretty. If you are warm toned, I think it will enhance your features. For me, as I said, I look like I have been punched in the face if I use a yellow blush. I tried it. Also, if I have an orange blush on that is too yellow, it also looks like I have been punched in the face. And unless that's the look I'm going for, it usually isn't. So yeah, so I would use this as eyeshadows. But I think this is fun. I think this looks fun, and I really like Lunatic Cosmetics, their aesthetic. I have heard mixed reviews about their eyeshadow formula though, and because they are a higher price point, I'm not really in the market to go out and try it, because if I don't like it, I cannot give it back. We cannot return makeup here unless I am allergic to it. Then I can, but that's... Yeah, usually not the case for me. I could lie, but I won't. I won't do that. So, unless I can swatch this in store, but I don't think we... No, I don't. I cannot swatch it in store because it's not sold in store here. But yeah, I don't know. It does look very, very cool. So let me know if you have ordered this. Let me know how it is. And... Yeah, I think it looks stunning. Let's next go to Our Darling. This is their highly anticipated Victorian Beauty Secrets palette. It's available on their site. The shade story is based upon famous cosmetic secrets that sometimes weren't so health conscious. Whether you're trying to bring out that translucent pallor or trying to get that perfect doe-eyed look using Belladonna, this is the palette for you. Yeah, back in the day... was not really healthy what they were doing. So I think that this is very cool that they have done it like this. I think that the color story is pretty. I think it's nice and I think it fits the theme. It's 100% vegan. It's cruelty free. You get 9 shades, as you see. 3 mattes, 3 mattes, 6 shimmers, and one of the shimmers is a shifter, I think. Then. I think that's what they mean. Yeah, so the shifter shade is a blue iridescent. Yeah, I think this is very, very cool. I think it's very cool. Have you tried the brand? I haven't. Again, also a brand that I have my eye on because I think what they're doing is very, very interesting. Yeah, let me know your thoughts down below. So let's next go to Base Blue Cosmetics because they are doing some interesting things again. I'm going to go, I hope that I can read everything because I am in my DM right now because I have not seen this on their Instagram. I asked the brand and I am allowed to talk about this. So what they're going to do is they're going to come out with, no, an eyeshadow collection. It says here, it's the artistic collection is consistent of 12 makeup palettes from eyeshadows to face powder, highlighters and bronzers. It's a tribute to the most prominent piece in history, a memoir for the greatest artists. The girl with the pearl that you see here is the first artistic eyeshadow palette to be released from the collection. It features 7 highly pigmented, universally flattering colors, from warm toned nude to bright yellow. Unleash your inner artist to create a timeless look. It's paraben free and not tested on animals. It will release the 6th of December. And when I saw the palette, I was like, this is so, so different. Because the palette, as you can see, I think I can capture the moving picture, and otherwise I will try to grab screenshots. But basically her face is the way that the palette is looking. And it's just so interesting. I haven't seen this done in this particular format. And it's just so, I think that they're a very innovative brand anyway. They are doing something very, very different. And the palette, it's just, it looks like the painting. And I think that's very, very unique. Now, is it easy to use? Maybe not. On the other hand, you can basically go into the different sections. If I had this, would I use it? I would at least once, because I wanted to know how the formula is. But I also think that this is a very cool piece to collect. You know, kind of like a collector's item. I cannot wait to see the other palettes in the collection, what they are doing. It's very, very exciting. The next thing that I have from them, I need to go back to my saved folder, is winter sponges. So where did I have the post here? So they're also going to release, no, stop it. The winter edition snowflakes makeup sponge. It's 6 pieces in the box that you see here. They are latex free and oil resistant. They're reusable and it says for effortless foundation application. This kind of reminds me of those old school wedges that are still being used. I remember back in the day, it was all we had. We did not have sponges like this. We had those wedges, and still the shapes are sometimes nicer to use than a rounded shape, if that makes any sense. So I think this looks cool. I think this looks very cool, and I think this could be very, very nice to use. Now I have the, you cannot see them, I have their ghost sponges there that will not get used. But the texture does feel very, very nice. So I will leave their site down below. Have you tried anything from them? Let me know down below. What else? Oh yes, the Stabby Stabbed Tattoo Cream. I should have mentioned this in the beginning. I forgot. This is a brand called Spooks and Spanks. And she is doing kind of spooky, gothic-y, witchy skincare and such, soaps and all that thing. And she is actually making a tattoo cream, and she's calling it the Stabby Stabbed Tattoo Cream. I love that. So the ingredients are colloidal, I don't know how I'm supposed to pronounce that, but colloidal oats, I think, for itch relief, and oats are known for that. Aloe vera for treating inflammation, and cocoa, shea and cocum butters to help regrow skin cells, and she's excited. I am too. I honestly, when I'm getting a new tattoo, I usually oil it up with board seed oil from The Ordinary, because that works very well for me. And then I just plop some, it's baby bottom cream. There is a specific cream. If you're Dutch, Bepanthen. If you're Dutch and you have tattoos, you know the brand Bepanthen. You know the tube with the baby butt. Oh yeah, don't be fooled, because the tube with the tattoo on it is exactly the same as the one for the babies. It's even priced the same. It's the exact same cream. It's just in different packaging. I know, because I tried both. But I think this is fun, and I think that it could be very, very nice. I actually would not mind trying this. I am getting a new tattoo on the winter solstice, so at least that's the plan. So yeah, let me know your thoughts down below. And if you're a tattoo artist, she says here, contact her and maybe you can work something out. I will leave her site down below. Yeah, go check her out. I think it's cool. Oh yeah, the next thing is not so cool, unfortunately. Because I have here, you see what it says, right? Closing down sale, and it's from Lucky Bunny Cosmetics. She is quitting the business, or she is shutting down the business. It's a shame. I remember when I found her brand, it was with, she was doing the Seven Deadly Sins, and I saw the first palette. I still have the palettes that, all the palettes that she released, I have here. And it was just such an interesting color story, because it was green, and it was, there were some grays in there, there were some dark purples in there, almost, no, maybe dark berry even. It was such an interesting color combination. She released, I think she has 4 palettes. And then, yeah, well, COVID happened and she got pregnant. She had the baby. Basically, life happened. So we hadn't heard from her in quite a while. And she now decided to shut down the business. If you are eyeing any of the products, it is 50% off. You can use code BYEBYE to grab yourself a bargain before she sells out. Once it's gone, it's gone. And I will link her site down below. I have done videos with all her palettes. I have a code, but don't use my code because it's 10%. Go use this code BYEBYE and yeah, you know, grab what you want to grab. I think that the quality is very, very nice, especially the ones from her eyeshadow palette. Yeah, I'm sorry to see her go, but I wish her all the best in life. You know, being a mom, it's a full-time job, honestly. That's it. Good luck on whatever you are deciding to do next. And if it's, you know, I almost want to say just being a mom, and I don't mean just being a mom, because being a mom, as I said, it's a full-time job. Yeah, I wish you all the best, girl, and I hope that you are amazingly happy and that you will have the best life that you can imagine. Yeah. And again, I will leave the site down below. Next, I'm going to go to She Glam, because She Glam is releasing the Glitz List collection. And actually, when I saw this, I was like, ooh, kind of thing. It kind of makes me think of BH Cosmetics, but it's not. Let's see. It's an eyeshadow palette. A glittery eyeliner set contains four full-sized eyeliners. It's a baked highlighter, a lip gloss set, highlighter brush, a false lashes set. And I see in the thing 2 styles. There's also an innovative glitter sponge. The full collection retails for $34. You can search the product ID, which I will leave down below. But if you type on Shein, type in the Glitz List, it should come up. But I will leave the ID down below. Yeah, I think this is a nice collection. I think this could be a nice gift for someone. I'm still kind of eyeing the collection that I mentioned last week with all those duochromy stuffs. I have things in my cart. I haven't bought it yet, but I have things in my cart. I'm not planning on picking this up, but it does look pretty. And maybe it is, you know, a very cool gift for someone. And I will link Shein down below, or at least, yeah. Shein, yes. Right? Yeah, wow. Next I have, oh yes, R.E.M. Beauty by Ariana Grande. I did not mention it last week because I did not have enough information. I can see her in it, though. Is it exciting? No, it's not, but I think it's pretty much her, and I think it's kind of a well-rounded thing as well. You have some warmer neutrals, you have some more rosy-toned neutrals, and then you have your cooler mauvey type. I think for a first release of a new brand, I don't hate this. What else do we have? Oh yeah, we have some lippies. Oh, the eyeshadow palettes will retail for $24. There are also lashes for $16, mascaras for $15. Eyeliner for $19, liquid eyeshadows for $16, plumping glosses, there's a bunch. And I actually think that some of the things look very, very cool. Will I get anything? I don't think I will get anything right away. I don't even know if I can get it here or if it is just sold at the on her site. I have no idea if there are resellers, but I will leave her site down below. Let me know if you have ordered anything and are you excited? I am kind of meh about it. I don't dislike the fact that she's starting a makeup brand. I don't. But yeah, I'm kind of meh about it. It's not really something that I really want to invest in right now, at least. Okay. And this is one that people have been waiting for a collab, finally, with Doodles by the Bunny. And she is collabing with the brand called Milan Rowe Makeup. The palette is called Poison Ivy. And it is stunning. It's stunning. It's green. There are 2 blues in there. It's stunning. What can I say? Except the fact that it's stunning. Now, I know Doodles by the Bunny because I am, if I'm not I am subscribed to her, right, on Instagram? I thought I was, at least. Yeah, see, I am. I did not know the brand, though. But I am subscribed to her. I think I also have swatches. Yes, so let me save the swatches as well. It looks cool. Oh, they're not really blues. Maybe they're a little bit more gray blue. Yeah, I can see the colors of poison ivy, because there are different kinds of poison ivy. Or at least there are different kinds of ivy. And I like this a lot. Will I buy it? I was not really planning on it. Just because I have quite a few things to get to. Also, I don't know if the brand ships internationally, honestly. I will leave the site down below. Yeah, that's basically it. Let me know your thoughts. Did you order? Let me know. I think this looks stunning. And congratulations on this amazing collab. The people were waiting for it. It looks very, 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 very pretty. Yes, let me know if you have picked it up. Okay, let's next go to... What else do I have? Oh yes, let's go to a Madage Beauty. No! Madage Beauty London, because they are coming out with their Christmas Romance collection. The collection contains 6 new INV single eyeshadows, 16 new shades in their single eyeshadows, 5 new liquid lipsticks, and 3 new highlighting balms. It has launched already, so I will leave the site down below. You can save 30% with code SUPERGLAM. Yes, I don't know if it will go for the entire site or just their collection. I do know that my discount code works for the entire site, but I'm guessing that this one does as well. And, you know, use this code because it's 30% minus 10, so it's only, you know, save more. Yeah, the colors look pretty. I do really like their liquid lipsticks. I think the formula is very, very nice. I have a bunch of them here. Their eyeshadows, I really like the formula of the single eyeshadows. I am not a single eyeshadows person, though. So I have tried a few. And formula-wise, they are very, very nice. So if you like stuff like this, I will leave the site down below. I think that the colors are very pretty. But yeah, as I said, I'm just more of a palette person. What can I say? So... yeah, if you like singles though, these are definitely ones to check out. Okay, let's next go to... Oh yes, I was very confused by this. Let's next go to NYX Cosmetics, because they are collaborating or have collaborated with Money Heist, which is called La Casa de Papel. I have no idea what it is. I have Netflix and I have seen it floating by, but it's not something that I'm interested in at all. So when this one was announced, I was like, huh? Now, I have heard that it is a combination between two shows that I am familiar with, and I forgot which ones they are, but it, yeah, I don't think it's kind of an Italian crime series or something, mob series. It's not so... Hell, I watched one episode of The Squid Game, and I was like, yeah, I don't find this interesting at all. But maybe I need to see more episodes. But the first one, I was like, my Instagram reels are more exciting. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's me. I was like, is that show known for its makeup? I don't know. I have no idea. This is a collab that I am like, maybe I should do a video about questionable collabs. Maybe I should do that. Maybe that's fun. I have seen some other YouTubers do that and I always find them fun to watch. But maybe it is funny as hell if I'm kind of bitchy for, I don't know, 20 minutes. Especially if maybe I can, I don't know, use an adult libation at the same time. Let me know if that is of interest to you, because this is certainly a contender, because I don't understand this at all. I like We Are the Resistance. The smaller eyeshadow palette, yeah, I like the color story. It's, what can I say, it's a warm color story. For the rest, I like the highlighter brush, I like the eyeliners, the eye pencils. I really like the eye pencils from NYX, but for the rest, it's not interesting for me at all. Is The Mandalorian, is that logical to do a makeup collab with? No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. You are completely right. But yeah, I want that one. So I find that interesting. This, I don't. Let me know your thoughts. Maybe you are the opposite. Let me know down in the comment section. Let's next go to... Oh yeah, last week I mentioned that Revolution Pro is collaborating with the Marilyn Monroe Estate. Or at least that's what I think it is. And I have the collection here. So basically it's an eyeshadow palette. And it's called the Ultimate Shadow Palette Diamonds. It's £20 or $28. Then there is an eye quad white pearl. An eye quad pink crystal, and then a lip set red, lipstick and a liner, and then there's a nude set also lipstick and a liner. There's a highlighter, a makeup bag, a compact mirror, and a volume mascara and eyeliner set. The volume mascara and eyeliner set I get, yes. Compact mirror I get, yes. Makeup bag, yes, I get. Highlighter, yeah. The lip sets, the reds and the nudes, I actually get. And I know that there are her iconic pictures. She has a wing and a red lip. But she did not always have a red lip. Because I have also seen a bunch of pictures from her where she's just in minimal makeup and has a nude lip on. So I get that. I like what they have done with diamonds on the outside. I like it a lot. I think that the quads are pretty as well. And I kind of feel like they would go with her vibe. I don't know if they're all shimmers though. I have no freaking idea. Yeah, I like the mirror as well. I think that's very pretty. The quads, looking at it, are all shimmers, I think. The bigger palette looks to have two neutral mattes or three neutral mattes. And then the rest shimmers. I can kind of see why they put in a hot pink. Not that I don't remember seeing her with hot pink eyeshadow, but I can kind of see why there's a hot pink. And then the other quad looks to be also shimmer. So it's very, very shimmer heavy. I am not really hating this collection. It's more than I thought that they would do. Does it scream Marilyn Monroe? Maybe not specifically. Let me know your thoughts. I'm kind of on the I don't know category. I like the pearl quad. I like the way that it is looking on the outside. I really like the way that it's looking on the outside. If I were to get anything from this, it would probably be the mirror. Because the highlighter is an icy white. I don't go for that. I could see myself getting the nude lip set. But overall, am I disappointed? Not really. Not really. It's kind of on the expectation that I had. So let me know your thoughts. Did you get anything? Oh yes, and don't forget, if you shop the Revolution site, use code TRENDMOOD for 20% off. If you know another code that gives 20% off, let me know down in the comment section. And I will basically pin it as a comment and we'll write it down and then hopefully not forget to mention it next time that I'm talking about Makeup Revolution. Okay, let's next go to Makeup Maniacs, because they are releasing a 6-pan eyeshadow palette, or have released it already. It's the Holiday Bliss palette, 3 mattes, 3 shimmers. It retails for $16. Yeah, it's live now. And it is a yellow, a green and a red in matte and shimmer. I like that. Very simple. You can mix and match, you can customize. Well, the only two that you usually cannot mix together are the green and the red, but you could use maybe yellow transition, red in the crease, and then green underneath your eye, or vice versa, you know, something like that. I think this looks fun. I think this is a fun little palette. Yeah, I like it. What can I say? Let me know your thoughts down below. Yeah, last week at the end I mentioned, or at least I saw that Manny had released a new collection, which is a face palette, lippies and a brush set. The lippies looked very, very pretty. The face palette looks like something I would not use at all. So yeah, that's, I like the way the outer packaging is looking, but it's not for me at all. What else? The lippies, yeah, I love his lippies. I love his liquid lipstick formula. I love his gloss formula. I can see myself, if this comes to Boozy Shop, and I think it will, I can definitely see myself picking up a few of the lippies. Yeah, that's the, yeah, especially the liquid lipstick. Yeah. that's honestly the only thing that I would really want from this collection, because the rest is not, it's not what I go for. I'm very particular with my brushes, so brush sets, especially if they're a combination of face and eye brushes, I very rarely buy. And I don't use face palettes, so that is not for me. Those lippies though, yeah, I'm going to get me some when they launch on Boozy Shop, yeah. Next is Glaminatrix, because this is the full reveal of the Silent Night palette. It is live already. It went actually live last week, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know if she still has in stock, because once sold out, they won't be returning. So I am not sure if it's still in stock. I will link it down below. And if it's not in stock anymore, I'm very sorry. It does look pretty. Yeah, that's it. It looks pretty. And I get why they're putting in a blue. It's just not what I would go for. But that's because blue is not really my favorite eyeshadow palette to use usually. I'm very much into the greens. But this looks stunning. Let me know if you've ordered it. Let me know down below. Then I have from Loka Lashes, a collab between Loka Lashes and Danny Sauce. This is their Por Vida y Más palette. Por Vida. Vida is life, right? So for life and... I actually don't know. I don't feel like finding out through Google. So let me know what it means. I think that this palette looks stunning. I don't know if there are glitters in there. It says 9 shades. It's available already. It looks stunning. I love this color story. No. Can I zoom in? Yeah. I don't know if there are glitters though. But I love the way this is looking. I love the color story. I love the artwork. I really, really love it. Again, I don't know if there are pressed glitters in there. But it's... Yeah, what can I say? It looks stunning. So that's why I wanted to mention it. And I will leave the site down below. What else do I have? Oh yes, I have something from X Revolution. They have released blush tints. 4 shades. It's a serum liquid blush. And I am actually very interested. Wait... It's uniquely formulated with a trio of essential oils, clementine, ginger, and cinnamon. I don't know if I want to put that on my cheeks though. But honestly, I have one in my wish list. Yeah, can you guess the one that I have in my wish list? So basically the shade Perfection I have in my wish list. The shade Dainty looks pretty as well. I don't think that I will pay full price for them, but if they are on sale, it could very well be that I will try one. Yeah, and if I don't like them, at least they will smell nice. Then the last thing that I have is from BH Cosmetics, and it is their holiday collection. Now, it has been floating around on the internet. The videos are up already. The only thing that I like from this collection is the trio with the yellow, the green, and the greens in there. For the rest, I don't know. And it was the same last year as well. I don't know. I felt very much underwhelmed by BH Cosmetics' holiday release. I heard that the quality of at least a smaller palette last year, I think, was very good. But I find this not appealing at all. Am I alone in that? And I love BH Cosmetics. I really, really love BH Cosmetics. But looking at this collection, I kind of thought it was Morphe. I don't know if that's a good comparison though. But I know that Angelica picked up... I think she picked up the big palette, or did she pick up the smaller palette? I don't know. But I know that she picked one palette up for science. That's what she said. And I believe her. Obviously, it's for science. Well, I'm going to let the science in her hands. I like science, but not that much. No, I'm not going to pick anything up from this collection because it's not me at all. But maybe you ordered it. Maybe you are over the moon. Let me know down below. And then those were all the releases that I wanted to mention today. It was a long video again. A lot of sneak peeks. So yeah, I cannot wait to see all the final palettes, all the final color stories. And if I know more information, I will let you know, and otherwise we will talk about it again next week, or maybe even the week after that. I'm still here at the site because it's also my weekly shout out for my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And what do you get for being a member? You get a colored raven behind your name. You also get special emojis to be used in the comment section and in live chat. And there is a monthly members only video. There's also a playlist. If you are a member, you can watch the playlist. You don't have to wait. There's no waiting period. You can watch immediately. Yeah, that was it. That was it for today. And if you're still here, leave me a black heart emoji because I have poofy shoulders. That was it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon for my next one. Bye, guys.